Here's an example of linked list mutation. Let's say we have an ordered list with no repeated elements. And we want to maintain the fact that S is an ordered list with no repeated elements, but write a function add that places elements into the list in the appropriate position so that everything stays ordered from least to greatest. So here's the function. Add to a list S a value V, which modifies S to make sure that it contains V, and then returns that modified S. However, if V is already in S, then we don't modify S so that we don't have repeats in the list. But we still want to return S from the add function. Now is a good time to pause the video and try to write this function. I'm going to describe how it works in 3, 2, 1. When you add 0 to S, we'll make sure that 0 is the element at the beginning, and that 1 comes after that. Instead of rewriting all of the values in the list, we can do this just by creating a new link instance whose first element is 1, changing S so that its first element is 0, and rerouting so that the rest of S is the link instance whose rest is 3, then 5. Now we have a linked list representing the sequence 0, 1, 3, 5, instead of just 1, 3, 5. If we add 3, we should look through S until we find the place that 3 goes, and since we discover that 3 is already there, we're not going to modify S at all. We'll just return it. And what if we add 4? Well, we look along here until we figure out where 4 would go, between 3 and 5. So that means we can change the 5 to a 4, add a new link instance for the 5, and now we have 0, 1, 3, 4, 5. And what if we add 6? Well, that's actually a little bit different. We keep looking until we find that we've reached the end. So, instead of rest being link.empty, rest needs to be a new link instance containing the 6. That's how we add V into S. Try to implement it. Add V into S, returning modified S. Don't change S if V is already there, and make sure that S remains ordered. We assume that S is ordered at the beginning, and we have to place V into S so that the order remains from least to greatest. Here are some examples. If S is 1, 3, 5, and we add 0, then it's 0, 1, 3, 5. We add 3, and it doesn't change. We add 4, and the 4 shows up in the right place. And we add 6, it ends up at the end. And let's assume that S is not empty to begin with. How can we do it? Well, we'll assert S is not empty. And then, if S.first is greater than V, we mutate S by changing S.first and S.rest. If S.first is less than V and S.rest is empty, then we have to place a value at the end. If S.rest is less than V, we got to do something, and in the end we return S. Why don't you pause and try to fill in the blanks, and we'll talk about it in 3, 2, 1. If S.first is greater than V, then we place V as S.first and change S.rest to contain the old S.first and the old S.rest. That's building this link instance or building this link instance. If S.first is less than V and the rest is empty, then we need to build this link instance by setting S.rest to a link where V is the first element and the rest is empty, which is the default second argument for link. Otherwise, we keep looking for the place where we're going to put V, which is just a recursive call to add. We don't need to return because we're going to return down here. We're always going to return S. The point of this call is not to compute a value to return, but instead to perform the addition on the rest of S.